Why, hello there. Hey guys, it's Camo here. And today, I'll be attempting to make pizza rolls. First, we're going to get started with dough. Now that dough's nice and thick, and we're going to take another bowl and now we're going to take a nice dry towel, we're going to place it over the top of the bowl, and we're going to leave it in here for about an hour so it can rise. Hey guys, welcome back. I decided that while we wait for the dough to rise that we would make our pizza sauce. So what I'm going to be using is some simple garlic salt and some sugar. I'm just going to sprinkle around some garlic salt. That's interesting. Mm-hmm. Right, so the garlic salt doesn't seem to want to come out, so we'll have to make our own. I'm going to utilize a measuring cup. I'm going to pour in some iodized salt. And some garlic powder. And on the back of the garlic salt, it says to add a bit of parsley in there. So now I'm just going. So now I'm just gonna put it all inside of the tomato sauce. Now I'm just going to add a bit of sugar. I'm just going to give this a little bit of taste. And that tastes pretty good. So now all we have to do is wait for our dough to rise, and I'll see you then. Hey guys, welcome back. I preheated the oven to 450 degrees, and the dough should be finished rising since I've given it about an hour to rise. Oh, that's a lot. Very nice. So here we are at the counter. We will be using these later on. So we got our pizza sauce. We have two different types of cheese and our pepperoni. Now, since the pizza rolls they're always cubed, the pepperoni is always cubed. I cut them up into little bits, and we're also gonna make a hot pocket. So I have whole pepperonis right here. And I noticed whenever you eat a pizza roll, it's kind of buttery and it's very thin, so we have some butter to put on it. Now we have this all nice spread out. I'm gonna cut this into square sections. So. Welcome to this side of the kitchen. Now this isn't all the pizza rolls that I'm gonna make. I'm gonna make some more. And we're also gonna make a hot pocket, so. First we're just gonna put the sauce on our rolls. Here we have our pepperoni, which I'm just going to sprinkle on. Now for the cheese. I'm gonna fold up them. Here we have our butter. I don't have a brush, so I'm just gonna put this at the top. Now I'm gonna make a few more of these and I'll see you whenever. Hey guys, welcome back. I made the rest of my pizza rolls and now we're gonna move on to making our Hot Pocket. All right, so now that we're over here, I have a bit of butter and garlic and I'm just gonna spread this out on the dough. It smells like garlic bread now. I'm gonna give it a garlic bread taste. And here we have our sauce, so I'm just gonna put it in a straight line and I'm gonna spread it out. Some mixed Monterey Jack and cheddar on it. Then a few pepperonis. then I'm gonna roll it. Run around there. Now on the roll, I'm just putting butter wherever you roll that. Spread it out nice and smooth. Repeat the process of putting tomato sauce. Three pepperonis. Roll. Butter the roll. Rinse and repeat. And here's our final roll. The rest of our cheese. Put it on there. Pepperonis. Let it up. Fold the corners. Butter it at the top.
Now we have all of our stuff prepared, and all that's left to do is put it in the oven at 450 degrees for. I'm gonna put it in for about 15 minutes. Here we go. Welcome back, guys. It's now 15 minutes later, or rather 14. I had to cut it short because I thought it was going to burn. And I'm ready to take a piece of gold out of it. First of all, I was right, it was beginning to char a little bit, but that's okay, because pizza crust is supposed to do that.
It's supposed to be crunchy, it's supposed to be, you're supposed to enjoy.
So here we have our plate, it's too small. these off the tray and put them on our plate. I'm glad they didn't merge into one another. Like this one. Nice, now we have all of our contents compiled into one dish. Now I'm gonna put some of these on a separate plate so I can show you a cross section or a demonstration, because I'm gonna give these to the rest of my family as well. Hi, hello. Here we have two types of pizza rolls that I made. This one was made off camera, where instead of folding it from a square, I made it into a swirl by actually rolling it. And here are the two different cross sections of each kind. This is the one I made on camera. You can see it's not really spaced out, but you still have all the contents in one area instead of having crust there. Here's the cross section for the one that I made off camera. As you can see, this one has its contents are evenly distributed, and even though there is crust in the middle, it distributes the contents. The one that I made off camera distributes the crust and contents evenly, and they are spaced throughout, whereas the one I made on camera, the contents are in one area and you do have the same amount of crust, but they are all in one central place. Yes, obviously both of these do taste the same, but it does taste nice whenever I added the butter on it. It's very crisp whenever you bite into it. The crust isn't really revolting as you would eat, let's say on a pizza. Most people don't really eat the crust, and I think that's kind of disgusting because you should eat the whole entire piece of pizza, but here I'm on pizza rolls. You can eat the whole entire thing and it's still good. Now, here we have our Hot Pocket.
that I made earlier, just like the pizza roll I made, it also has several layers, and it's made with garlic butter instead of just regular butter on top. It also is thin. Contents are just evenly distributed. And its taste is very pleasant. As though you had made garlic bread into a pizza entirely. You can definitely taste the butter. That provides like extra flavor. Really good. Anyway, that's gonna have to do it for today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.